Researchers have discovered a new type of material for the next generation of semiconductors, and it consumes up to a billion times less energy. That's exciting, and I will break it down in this video for you, and I will wrap it up with my list of top 5 technological breakthroughs of 2024. Let's see if this one makes it to the list. In 1965, Gordon Moore predicted that the number of transistors per chip will double roughly every 2 years with a minimum increase in cost. But what's really been doubling over the last couple of years is the number of people saying that Moore's law is dead. Well, it's not. Not by a long shot. Just a few days ago, TSMC presented their progress on 2-nanometer devices that they will be shipping already next year. And this is one of the most anticipated developments on the market because it marks a huge milestone for the industry, which is right now transitioning from FinFET devices to nanosheet architecture. With that, we get 15% increase in transistor density, 30% improvement in power, with a cost per wafer up to 50% higher than the wafers in 3-nanometer process. Well, looking at these numbers, Moore's law is not dead, but we can definitely see that it's slowing down, with devices reaching its physical limits. And this is especially the case for memory technology, which is really struggling over the last years to make the same leap. To overcome this, industry players have been actively looking into new materials and new architectures for the post-silicon era. Among them are silicon carbide, graphene, gallium nitride, carbon nanotubes, and of course other 2D materials like TMDs such as molybdenum disulfide. At the same time, research has been investigating alternative technologies like Josephson junction transistors for quantum computing and probabilistic computing, to photonics, to biological computing. And all of these technologies I've covered on this channel. Subscribe right now to watch them later on. With all of those promising technologies, the advancements in materials can give us huge leaps forward, potentially by many orders of magnitude. And just recently, the researchers from MIT and the University of Pennsylvania School of Engineering discovered a new material, indium selenide. And it turned out to have some very interesting properties for semiconductors. It actually has a unique combination of ferroelectric and piezoelectric properties. What are those? Ferroelectric means that it can spontaneously polarize, so it can generate internal electrical field without an external charge. On the opposite side, its piezoelectric property allows it to generate internal charge as a response to applied mechanical stress. It turns out, when we apply current to it, it causes an effect similar to what happens during an earthquake. It triggers a chain reaction. It begins with tiny deformations within the material, and then it spreads further, like an avalanche. And so, the combination of these properties, its two-dimensional structure, ferroelectricity and piezoelectricity, allows us to use this effect for writing information and storing information in the device. One of the first applications is in so-called phase change memory, which is considered to be one of the most promising memory technologies of the future. And it's called phase change because it undergoes the transition between phases, liquid and solid. And it can actually retain the values without power supply. This memory, right now seen as a potential future replacement for memory that can replace both short-term memory, RAM, as well as SSDs in your laptops. Typically, such a memory device consists of a special glass-like material which is sandwiched between two electrodes in the middle. Generally, it can switch between two states. Crystalline, where atoms are neatly ordered. Think of the structure of a diamond. It makes it strong and clear. And an amorphous state, where atoms are randomly ordered without a regular pattern, which makes the material more flexible. why this memory is so interesting. Because unlike binary memory, which we have nowadays, right, which can store zeros and ones, this memory can record a continuum of values, which means it can store any value in between zero and one. And that's really beneficial because with that we can do in-memory computing, basically eliminating the main bottleneck of the modern computing systems. Then why this technology hasn't reached widespread adoption yet? It turns out, so far, the way we were recording, writing values in the memory was sort of heating and melting techniques, which is very energy-consuming, expensive, and really hard to scale. That's one of the reasons why this technology hasn't reached widespread use yet. And guess what? These new devices built of this unique material, indium selenide, are solving all these complications. And according to the paper, require as little as billion times less power compared to the previous designs. We will discuss the implications of this in a moment, but before this, I want to discuss the technology that's already available right now and already transforming how we work today. Whether you're a small business or a large enterprise, AMD Ryzen PRO processors deliver advanced performance to handle your most demanding workloads. At the core of the AMD Ryzen PRO processor is the cutting-edge architecture that integrates a CPU, GPU, and a dedicated NPU on a single chip, enabling up to 1.8 times faster performance for your favorite AI-powered applications. And this performance is paired with advanced security features and incredible efficiency. AI PCs powered by the Ryzen PRO series deliver up to 84% lower power consumption for office workloads, giving you the freedom to work from anywhere all day long. Now to the best part. AMD is making it easy right now for businesses to see the impact firsthand with their free loaner program. Just click the link below to test Ryzen PRO laptops for yourself and see the benefits it can bring to your business. Now, back to the innovation. These new memory devices, based on this unique material, significantly lowering the power requirements and could potentially lead to more efficient universal memory, memory which can give us the speed of RAM with the storage capacity of SSD. And in general, this material opens up a possibility of building new, more efficient devices. That all sounds great, but there is a catch. Indium selenide is a relatively rare material when we compare it to silicon, because silicon is the second most abundant element on the Earth after oxygen. And then indium is a relatively rare material, which will make the production quite costly. And then we actually need to synthesize this indium selenide and to come to a relatively high yield, which is going to be quite complex. However, probably the biggest challenge is going to be its integration with existing systems. Bringing it into the current semiconductor manufacturing process will be challenging and expensive. And this will likely take decades. Of course, when we're talking about new materials, sometimes they seem too far from hitting the shelves. And I get this comment very often from you. Why do you break down these technologies which will not end up in my laptop in the next 5 years? And I don't get that. You know, for example, in case of silicon, from the time of original experiments in the late 40s till the moment when it hit the first commercially viable, more or less useful application, it took at least 2 decades. You know, great things take a lot of time. Now, I'm working on a silicon startup of my own, and it takes a lot of time. And I know some people who've been working on a particular technology for like 15 years, and no one cared about it for 15 years. Just imagine this. And eventually, they made it happen. And I really admire this perseverance, because sometimes we're like, oh, well, I tried for 3 days, not working out, probably not the best idea. I believe we can make anything to work unless you stop. That's the mindset. That's my message to you for 2025. Now, I want to briefly touch upon another alternative memory technology which can reach adoption in the nearer future. This is so-called computational RAM, CRAM. Very interesting innovation. It's a memory device that allows us to perform computations directly inside memory cells, which dramatically reduce power consumption. That's an in-memory computing approach, and it gets its efficiency from something called MGTs, magnetic tunnel junctions, which we touched upon in the previous video on probabilistic computing. Make sure to watch it, one of the best episodes on this channel this year. An MTG is a small device that, instead of relying on an electrical charge like traditional memory, using the spin of its electrons to store data. In one of the recent papers, researchers demonstrated that when we use computational RAM, we can perform some of the key AI workloads like matrix multiplication up to 2,500 times more energy efficient. And the thing is, we are already pretty good at manufacturing MGTs at scale. So it's something that we could benefit from in the near future for in-memory computing applications, as well as for probabilistic hardware. However, the efficiency gains here are much lower compared to the memory technology we discussed in the beginning. Even though this technology may take decades to get integrated into the real products, this field is making significant progress, and it's very exciting to watch. Now, I want to wrap up this video and this year with my list of top 5 most exciting advancements in the semiconductors of 2024. First of all, of course, the first fully functional graphene chip. This graphene chip is developed by Georgia Tech, and it overcomes the limitations of transistor technology. And this development may potentially spark a new era in electronics. Second, this year we saw huge advancements in photonic interconnect. And if photonic chips are still in the early phase, photonic interconnect is happening. And this is the next frontier which allows us to build larger GPUs, larger ASICs, by improving the communication bandwidth and efficiency between chiplets. Check out IR Labs and Light Matter Solutions. Third, in 2024, quantum computing field seen significant progress with the recent release of Google's quantum chip Willow, which is a big milestone in error correction and computational speed. I also saw this reflected in the quantum part of my investment portfolio, with quantum stocks just skyrocketing. But just keep in mind, these are the short-term gains, and there's a lot of excitement right now, but still, quantum computing is being useful for very specific tasks at the moment. Next, we saw this year a growing interest in probabilistic computing. It has been really gaining momentum with the first hardware platforms in development. And among startups is Xtropic, for example. This is a really exciting technology and a very interesting computing principle, which is very similar to the idea behind this year's Nobel Prize winner in physics. And I covered this technology, as well as all the other technologies from my list, on this channel, so I will be linking them below in the description box so you can watch it later. Finally, of course, AI technology, which is penetrating literally every field out there. For example, this year was huge for physical AI. And of course, AI is accelerating the hardware development as well as the development of algorithms. But at the same time, the progress in hardware, right, better GPUs, better ASICs that we are building, accelerating the development of AI. Interesting cross-pollination. And I bet we're going to see it accelerating even more next year. And it's going to be very exciting to watch. Despite all this progress, some aspects of AI remains not fully understood. For example, we don't know if models like GPT are really able to understand the meaning behind text and language, or just mimicking their training data. But actually, some of the recent papers published this year show that after extensive training, models can really combine and derive and master specific knowledge, which is not directly derived from the training data. And that's very interesting. Let me know what are your favorite technologies of 2024 in the comments. Now, I want to take a moment to thank you for being here this year, for watching my videos, for your insightful comments, for your support, for your feedback. This community means the world to me. And I tried to make today's setup a little bit more festive, and I want to wish you Merry Christmas. Please try to take time for yourself and to recharge over Christmas period, because we all work too much. And get ready for the next year full of new exciting technologies, which we will be discussing on this channel. Thank you guys. Love you guys.